It is indeed another privilege and a blessing to be here this morning to bring a word. As ministers, sometimes the word that we bring makes us a little nervous. This one had me nervous this morning, but the Holy Spirit has led me to bring this word, and I believe that it will bless somebody this morning. God bless you as we go into our devotion today. Let us pray. Father, we thank you for this day. We thank you, Lord, that you are faithful. We thank you, Lord, that you are all righteous. We thank you, Lord, that you are with us no matter what the trial, no matter what the test. We thank you, Lord, that you have made provision for us. You never leave us and you never forsake us. Bless this word in my mouth this morning, Father, and bless the ears to hear as we receive from you, Lord, as you speak to us in the mighty name of Jesus. Let the words of my mouth and the meditation of my heart be acceptable in your sight, O Lord, my strength and my redeemer. I'm reading this morning from Colossians 2, verses 6 to 7, from the New King James Version. I already feel the presence of God here. Colossians 2, 6 to 7, the New King James Version. As you have therefore received Christ Jesus the Lord, so walk in him, rooted and built up in him, and established in the faith as you have been taught, abounding in it with thanksgiving. The title of this devotion this morning is Rooted and Grounded. Rooted and Grounded. When I read this verse telling us to be rooted and built up in Christ, I think of security, strength, growth, and fruit. If we look at a tree, all these qualities come into play. If a tree does not have strong roots, its security and strength are compromised, and it will be impossible for that tree to grow and produce fruit. As children of God, we are to be rooted and grounded in Christ in order to be secure, strong, growing to maturity in our Christian walk and producing fruit in the kingdom. This verse of scripture is admonishing us that we should have our roots in Christ Jesus, built up in him, established in the faith, so that we can mature spiritually in him. Psalms 1 and 3 reminds us that the person who walks with Christ shall be like a tree planted by the rivers of water that brings forth its fruit in its season, whose leaf also shall not wither, and whatever he does shall prosper. Whatever he does shall prosper. Another verse of scripture likens a person who trusts in God to a strong tree. In Jeremiah 17 and 8, it reads, "For he shall be like a tree planted by the waters, which spreads out its roots by the river and will not fear when heat comes, but its leaf will be green and will not be anxious in the year of drought, nor will cease from yielding fruit." This tree is grounded, so the heat and the lack of water does not diminish its fruit or its growth. As I reflect on this verse, I am reminded of my coconut tree that survived after Category 5 Hurricane Erma in 2017. That was Erma with an I. This week, we here in BVI remembered Hurricane Erma in 2017, which brought so much devastation to our islands. A lot of trees in my yard were blown down, all over the porch, all over the yard. But there was this one coconut tree that my husband decided that he would try to save. It was a big tree. As a matter of fact, it was so big that it crushed the fence where it fell. It was tall, but unfortunately the root, hallelujah, was not strong enough to withstand the storm. The strong winds tore the roots out of the ground. My husband asked some men to help him to pull up the tree, and they tied it with rope to the fence on one side to another big tree and to the house. Then he poured dirt over the exposed roots until they were totally covered. God brought this analogy to me in the early morning yesterday as I awoke from sleep. and I had to get up and write. And I'm giving you the exact words that God gave me. That's why I said I'm nervous this morning. Somebody this morning, the storm caused you to fall. But God said, this one will live. He sent some people to pull you back up. But you took offense. You are offended because you didn't want anybody to see you in that fallen state. You are offended because somebody straightened you up. You think that they were too rough on you when they pulled you up. You are offended because they covered your roots with the word of God in order to strengthen you. That's because your roots were exposed. They were not grounded in the soil. The word you received covered your roots to make you stronger. You are offended because you feel that they tied you up. Because they said, stay in this position and God will cause you to grow. They said, don't move from this place where he has planted you. Those ropes of the word were to hold you in place to make sure your roots grow downward so that you could grow upward. But guess what? The ropes on my coconut tree are no longer necessary. Its roots are holding it in place. Hallelujah, Jesus. The ropes came off because it is strong enough to stand, hallelujah, based on its foundation. Its roots are grounded in the soil. Now that you are strong, your roots are holding you in place. You have been rooted and grounded in Christ Jesus. Now the fruit is springing forth. Somebody will be blessed by your fruit, just like the water from my coconuts that I am getting from my tree. The living water flowing from you will bring life to someone else. Stay rooted and grounded in Christ. Don't move from that position. Stay where he is. Stay where he has planted you. Your roots are growing stronger. You are growing taller. Your fruit, hallelujah, is blessing somebody else. God allowed you to go through the storm. He saw you fall, but he made a way for you to be pulled up, covered up, so your roots were not exposed. Then he strengthened you by the word so that you might not die spiritually, but live to declare the works of the Lord, rooted and grounded in the word of God. When we are rooted in Christ, adverse situations and circumstances may come into our lives. But because our roots are secure in Christ and our strength comes from him, we will stand secure. Ephesians 3, 17 to 19 reads that Christ may dwell in your hearts by faith, through faith, that you being rooted and grounded in love may be able to comprehend with all the saints what is the width and the length and the depth and the breadth and the height. Let me read that again. May be able to comprehend with all the saints what is the width and length and depth and height, to know the love of Christ which passes knowledge, that you may be filled with all the fullness of God. In order to be rooted in Christ, we must be committed to him, dependent on him, and operate in his love. As we study the word of God and walk in right relationship with him, we will become rooted in him and strong in his word. Ephesians 4, 14 to 15 says that we should no longer be children tossed to and fro and carried about with every wind of doctrine by the trickery of men in the cunning craftiness of deceitful plotting. But speaking the truth in love, may grow up in all things unto him who is the head, Christ. When we are rooted and grounded in Christ, we can follow the encouragement given to us in 1 Corinthians 15:58, which was one of my dad's favorite verses. Therefore, my beloved brethren, be steadfast, immovable, always abounding in the work of the Lord, knowing that your labor is not in vain in the Lord. Stay rooted and grounded in Christ this morning. Be steadfast in the work God has called you to do. Be immovable because your roots are sound. Hallelujah, Jesus. And always abounding. That's an abundance. Always abounding in the work of the Lord. There is no scarcity with Christ. He wants us to work in abundance in his vineyard. Abounding in the work of the Lord. Because we know, hallelujah, that our labor is not in vain in the Lord. When we labor to pull up our coconut tree in 2017, our labor now is not in vain. Our tree is loaded with nuts. And we have picked so many over the years. Stay rooted and grounded. You are producing fruit because your root is sound. Yeah. Jesus, stay rooted and grounded in Christ this morning. Father, I thank you this morning for this word that you have given unto us. Help me as your child to stay rooted, grounded in your word. The storms may come, God, but Lord, don't let my roots be exposed. Cover me with your blood, Father. Cover your children this morning, mighty God. Cover us, Father. Uphold us with your righteous right hand. Strengthen our roots, hallelujah, that we may be grounded in you. Bless us together here at GGRFM. Let your word touch somebody this morning. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. Amen.